There is new Pepsi Tesla Semi sighting, which shows three cameras in the mirror and one under the license plate. And this is going to answer one of the questions that one of you guys posted yesterday and was a very important question about truckers and Tesla Semi parking. One user on Reddit today has posted new images of Pepsi Tesla Semi in which he has shown some very good finds. This is a good find on the autopilot camera in the mirror. I wonder if that's the equivalent to a B-pillar camera since it is forward-facing. One close inspection, I see three cameras on that mirror. Do you see the same? And it's starting to feel like Hardware 4's extra camera spot are for supporting the Semi. Friends, we're talking about three cameras in each side mirror of Tesla Semi, side, rear, and down. The existence of these many cameras may shed some very good light to an earlier question that one of you guys yesterday posted, one of you, the YouTube followers, yesterday posted asking to show us a video of Tesla Semi parking at the dock. I have already sent requests to Frito-Lay and Pepsi asking if they will send me the video. I don't know if they will do that, but if you know anyone who has a video of Tesla Semi parking at the dock, please send it to me. I will post it here with comments. Now, Truckers wants to see how the driver in the middle seat sees how to park the Semi at the dock. Well, now I think the only way to park the Tesla Semi at a docking station is to use the cameras. And the existence of so many cameras convincingly explain it. Do you agree with that? What do you think, friends? Now, do you like the blue color of the Pepsi Tesla Semi? I think it's pretty good and I think it looks really nice on a Tesla Semi. Well, let me know if you see anything else in these images of new sightings of Tesla Semi, particularly cameras, or maybe you guys see something I didn't see. I'll look forward to hearing your comments in the comment section below. God bless you and let's continue on. Truckers have started to review Pepsi Tesla Semi and they find some very interesting things, especially a main issue with the center seats. There's an interesting discussion on Reddit about the Pepsi Tesla Semi truck, which hit the road a few weeks ago. Pepsi received them back in February or March, I think. They're like $250,000 a piece. Based on what modern ICE semis and passengers electric vehicle cost, this seems super reasonable to me, don't you think? But truckers who reviewed them are concerned about one particular issue, and actually more than one, and that has to do with Tesla Semi's center seat. Let's see what it is. The driver of the Tesla Semi is centered in the cabin. That's got to be strange for the driver, commented one trucker. Here's what the issue is. A user named PuddleSRS says he remembers hearing a trucker reviewing the center seat specifically. He says, this can become an issue if Tesla plans for a major rollout. I don't remember everything that the trucker said, he says, about the truck, but I do remember the seat. The main issue is arriving at gatehouses for deliveries at warehouses or factories or other such things. These gatehouses are set up so that a driver can hand over their paperwork to the guard without leaving their truck or out the driver's side window. If you put the driver in the middle, the driver has to leave their seat to hand over paperwork. This is suboptimal at best, they say, especially when you may have a line of trucks impatiently waiting behind you. Of course, if there is a regional distribution fleet, then the problem all but disappears. They check in at the home gatehouse where paperwork may not be required or they need to physically go into the office to check in. This would also likely be no gate at the delivery site and they would need to leave their truck anyway to make the delivery, he says. Now, you see, in order to design a semi-truck's cabin, you have to consult with truckers. Another huge issue is the entry to the Tesla Semi. One other user says, you have to enter from a back door and walk through the cabin to get to the driver's seat instead of a normal truck entering from right next to the driver's seat. What this means is in wet, mud, snow, etc., you have to walk with your filthy shoes through the entirety of your cab to get to the driver's seat versus what most drivers do of getting in just the driver's seat and slipping your shoes off when you go back into the rest of your cab living space when not driving to keep the rest of your cabin clean. Now, generally, truckers in this discussion, friends, think that Tesla Semi's designers should have more closely consulted with actual truckers so they know what their habits are and how they do their work. I'm sure Tesla has done it. I can't imagine Tesla hasn't done this, but at least this is what truckers say. Now, in my previous reports, I've spoken very favorably about the Tesla Semi. And in my opinion, from a logistical point of view, getting out of your seat would barely add any time to what truckers already have to go through. The time at the gate isn't the issue. The time at the dock is. That's what some truckers say. Now, waiting an hour plus for workers to show to unload is a bigger issue. Also, you know, truckers spend a lot of times and less hours by sitting in their trucks while driving. Maybe it's a little exercise, a little extra exercise and a little extra movement to get out of your seat, hand over your paperwork and then move back to your seat and continue driving. So what do you think about this? Apparently there are other issues and if hopefully someone from Tesla listens to these things, they can pass it to the Tesla designing team and they can come up with some improvements in the second edition of Tesla Semi or when they roll out the entire Semi truck in big quantities mass production. Tesla gigapress maker Hydra has released a new photo which you're seeing on your screen and says the future of die casting is not only gigapress but some more. They say this machine below will produce electric motor rotors. What it means? Welcome back again. This is Armin Haray and friends from torquenews.com. If you are here first time, please subscribe to this channel for daily Tesla breaking news. So Tesla gigapress supplier Hydra appears to have another disruptive machine in the works. And it might end up being used by key clients like the US-based electric vehicle maker Tesla. This was hinted at in a rather interesting image that was uploaded to social media on their LinkedIn account, which you're seeing on your screen. The company noted that the future of die casting is not only the gigapress. There is still quite a bit of innovation left in smaller segments, much smaller segments. The company posted a photo of component of one such machine on its official LinkedIn account. Hydra's new machine, as noted by the gigapress supplier, would be producing electric motor rotors. But while the company machine is interesting enough, EV advocates have observed that the component was painted in colors that look quite similar to those that have been delivered to Tesla. This is why I said this is very likely that Tesla will use this. While it is yet to be seen if Tesla will acquire such a machine from Hydra, the electric vehicle maker would probably need such a contraption when it starts the production of its compact electric car, which will be produced in Gigafactory Mexico. The vehicle, which is expected to be priced at around $25,000 range, is expected to see more production than the Model Y and Model 3 combined. Tesla's compact car will be produced on the company's next generation platform, which is designed to be significantly more efficient to produce than the Model 3 and Model Y, as noted by Tesla CFO Zachary Kirkhorn during in the 2023 Investor Day event. The next generation platform will enable a 50% reduction in costs. This means that the total cost of ownership of Tesla's next generation car will also be lower than the company's vehicles today. Such an estimate is quite impressive, friends, especially considering that the Model 3 is already cheaper to own than the Toyota Corolla today, as per the company during its 2023 Investor Day event. So Tesla is very likely to acquire this gigapress. Why? Because if this is going to produce electric motors, rotors, Tesla will need to do everything it can to lower the cost of its $25,000 car. And if Tesla acquires this type of machine, they can diecast them, make it cheaper to produce, and thus lower the cost of their $25,000 compact vehicle, making it more affordable and being able to sell them to more people at lower prices. So what do you think? Do you like this, friends? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below.